What's the simplest thing that could possibly work? That is a question that Ward Cunningham used to ask Kent Beck when programming to help them make progress when they were stuck. I decided to try to constantly ask this question when implementing a story in RLCI, and here's what happened. RLCI is a continuous integration system that I'm working on. For more information about it, check out the GitHub page. RLCI is installed on a machine in the cloud. Whenever I make a change to the RLCI repo, I run 0py integrate to integrate my changes. That will push my changes to a temporary branch and trigger the RLCI pipeline. The pipeline runs on the cloud machine, integrates the temporary branch, and provides feedback to the console. What we want to be able to do is to point a web browser at the machine in the cloud and have it present a report about its pipelines. To start with, it's enough if it prints information about the last pipeline run, similar to the output that we get in the console. RLCI is currently a command line application only, so now we need to introduce a server component, maybe we need to introduce a web framework. What web framework should we use in this Python context? And we also need to persist data about the pipeline run somewhere to be able to present it later on. Stop. What's the simplest thing that could possibly work? What if the command line application can generate an HTML report after it has run a pipeline and write it to a location that can be served as a static file? Could that possibly work? Let's see. I started by installing Nginx on my cloud machine. I had to enable HTTP in the firewall as well, but after that, it served a welcome page. Next, we need to configure Nginx to serve static files from a location that RLCI can write to. So currently, RLCI is deployed into opt/RLCI, and that directory is wiped every time that a new deploy of RLCI is made. So I think we need to modify the deploy script to actually put the code in a separate subfolder so that we can have a static folder where we can save files that are not wiped. Stop. What's the simplest thing that could possibly work? What if we committed a static file in a directory called HTML? On a cloud machine, that directory would be located in opt/RLCI/HTML. Could that possibly work? Let's see. I committed a hello world index.html file. Then I configured Nginx to serve static files from opt/RLCI/HTML. And voila, RLCI now serves an HTML report when we point a browser to it. This is obviously not good enough, you might think. And you're right. But one of the benefits of doing the simplest thing that could possibly work is that we get something on the screen sooner. And when we have something on the screen, we can criticize it and improve it. For me, the most obvious criticism right now is that the report is not really a report. It's just a static file with not much information. So let's extend this index.html file with all the pipelines and links to where you can see individual pipeline runs and what commands were run. Stop. What's the simplest thing that could possibly work? What if we just wrote the name of the pipeline that was triggered? Could that possibly work? Let's see. I created a new infrastructure wrapper for working with the file system. Then I wrote a new index.html file at the end of the trigger. And it works. Not much of a report still, right? But we did validate that this approach might actually work. We saw that the report was updated after the pipeline run, and it gives us some confidence that this will actually work. So now let's flesh out this report fully with all information about all pipelines and all runs. Stop. What's the simplest thing that could possibly work? What if we extend the database with just information about the last pipeline run? Could that possibly work? Let's see. I modified the database to support storing the latest commands run. Then I extended the code that logs commands to the console to also log the commands to the database. Dead simple. Almost stupid. When integrating changes, the report now changes to include the commands that were run. At this point, we have actually created enough to say that the story is completed. There are still many rough edges, but we have provided the value that the story talked about. When I look at what we have, I see the following criticism. So the first one is that only the last pipeline logs are shown. In this HTML view, we would like to be able to see all the pipelines and all the runs. So that's something we can continue working on. The second one is that the complete report is regenerated after each pipeline run. So a bunch of static files all generated every time a pipeline is run. And the third one is that the report looks kind of ugly. It's just basic HTML, no styling, so we can work on that as well. To solve the problem that static files are regenerated every time, we need to introduce a server component that can generate responses dynamically. Eventually, we will probably want to do that, but at this moment, as long as we have few pipelines and the logs are not that long, it's actually good enough to regenerate the whole report every time. So we can get away with it a little bit longer and delay implementing a server component. Doing the simplest thing that could possibly work led to progress faster. And it turned out that some things that I initially thought were needed to complete the story were not needed at all. So at least not needed yet. Maybe in the future, but we don't know for sure yet. So thanks, Ward, for the question. I'll see you in 1 week.